let's talk about a speed accuracy trade-off and what it means for us when we're doing transfer learning. I want to start by posing a question. Are deep networks always better? If you consider the ImageNet challenge, you'll notice that the story of improving performance has also been one of developing deeper and deeper architectures. While AlexNet has only 8 layers, the introduction of ResNets allowed to scale beyond 100 layers, and the current state of the art, the latest and largest efficient net, is more than 800 layers. On the other hand, from 2015 to 2017, the number of layers didn't really change substantially, but the error rate was still dropped by half. So while depth generally helps, other architectural features certainly also matter. Now, from a practical perspective, we don't really care about the number of layers. What we do care about is primarily how expensive is the network to compute and how accurate is it? And is there a trade-off between speed and accuracy? If you look at the performance of several modern ConvNets and how it depends on the number of floating point operations they require, you notice two things. First, many ConvNets are actually family of ConvNets. For instance, we've seen the BGG and the ResNet family. Within these families, there's a pretty clear relationship between their depth and the accuracy they deliver. Second, we also observe that across architectures, there's not a clear trade-off between speed and accuracy. Over the years, architectures have become increasingly efficient. While the accuracy has improved continuously, the compute budget required to achieve this accuracy has not really increased much. The latest addition in this journey of pushing efficiency is EfficientNet, published in 2019. It has again led to a substantial improvement in performance while being comparable to other earlier architectures in terms of floating point operations or number of parameters. The insight behind EfficientNet is how to scale networks properly. And this graph depicts a typical ConvNet. The colored boxes represent blocks of convolution layers. Typical ConvNet consists of 5 blocks that decrease image resolution, depicted by the height of the boxes, and increase the number of channels, depicted by the width of the boxes. To scale up such a ConvNet, we have 3 knobs that we can turn. First, the width. We can increase the number of channels. Second, the depth. We can add additional layers. And third, the input resolution. We can feed in higher resolution images. Most previous ConvNet families scaled only 1 or 2 of these factors and didn't really tweak their relationships much. The insight of EfficientNet was that one should scale all 3 simultaneously and that there is an optimal width and depth for each resolution. So there was no innovation here in terms of layer modules, but simply picking the right combination of these 3 hyperparameters. Now, since it's called EfficientNet and we've discussed MobileNet as a particularly efficient ConvNet before, you may wonder where the MobileNet lies in this plot. It's actually down here. So while it can't compete in terms of performance, it's also much smaller. The largest MobileNet is around the size of the smallest EfficientNet, so simply covering a different range in the spectrum. Everything we've discussed so far was about performance on ImageNet. But from a transfer learning perspective, do we care about ImageNet? What tells us that a model that performs well on ImageNet will also perform well on our downstream task? In fact, that's not clear at all. It's an empirical question. And those guys asked this question a while ago. And the answer turned out to be yes. They tested models pre-trained on ImageNet when fine-tuned onto 12 different image classification tasks. And they found a really strong relationship between the accuracy on ImageNet and the transfer accuracy on the downstream task. So what does this all mean for us when choosing a backbone for transfer learning? Well, we should ask ourselves whether speed or accuracy is the primary objective. If speed is particularly important, MobileNet is a good choice, since it's fast and still performs pretty well given the compute budget. If accuracy is the primary target, then we should just use the latest and strongest ImageNet model that we can get our hands on. Of course, in practice, it will also be important to consider whether code and pre-trained weights are available and whether they're easily accessible in our preferred code framework. For the exercise, we're going to explore different backbones from Torch Vision that were pre-trained on ImageNet, and we'll see how they fare on our Pokemon dataset, both in terms of speed and accuracy.